On March 4th, Ukraine's parliament accepted the resignation of Prime Minister Oleksiy Gончарук. Denis Shmigal, Ukraine's deputy prime minister, was appointed the new prime minister. In the past, Shmigal held a top management position at the energy company DTEC, owned by oligarch Rinat Akhmetov. The cabinet's reshuffle has led to a slew of new leaders. Deputy Prime Minister Dmytro Kuleba, who was previously in charge of integration with Europe, will now serve as the Minister of Foreign Affairs. The defense ministry will be led by Andriy Taran, a lieutenant general of the Ukrainian Armed Forces. Ihor Umansky became the finance minister. This position isn't new for him. He was finance minister under President Viktor Yushchenko. Vadim Pristaiko, Ukraine's current Minister of Foreign Affairs at the time of the reshuffle, will become Deputy Prime Minister for European Integration. Lieutenant General Serhiy Besarab will lead the Ministry of Veterans Affairs. Oleksiy Reznikov, a lawyer and deputy head of the Kyiv City Administration, was appointed Minister for Integration of the Occupied Territories and Displaced Persons. The Ministry of Health will be led by Ilya Yemets, a heart surgeon and head of the Pediatric Cardiology Center. Yemets was health minister in the government of Mykola Azarov under ousted ex-president Viktor Yanukovych. Marina Lazebna is the only woman in the new cabinet. She will lead the Ministry of Social Policy. The new minister of the Cabinet of Ministers will be Oleg Nemchinov. He served as the secretary of the Ministry of Youth and Sports. Vadim Gutsait, vice president of the Ukrainian Fencing Federation, became the new minister of Youth and Sports. The Ministry for the Development of Communities and Territories will be led by Alexei Chernyshov. He currently serves as the head of the Kyiv Oblast State Administration. Some ministers managed to save their positions. The controversial Arsen Avakov will continue to lead the Ministry of Internal Affairs. He has held that position for more than 6 years. Avakov has faced repeated accusations of stalling reforms and corruption. Vladislav Krikli will remain the Minister of Infrastructure. Denis Malyuska will remain at the helm of the Ministry of Justice. Mikhailo Fyodorov will continue to serve as the Digital Transformation Minister. Several seats in the cabinet remain vacant. It is still unknown who will lead these five ministries.